Hello my friend, in today's video we will take a look at Zhiyun Weebill 3. Weebill 3 is the fourth iteration in the Weebill series and the first significant departure from the original lab configuration. In this video we will take a look at the feature set and the performance of this gimbal in combination with Sony A7 IV, and I will try to help you decide whether it is the right gimbal for you. Before we get to the review, let me explain where the Weebill 3 fits in the Weebill lineup. In my opinion, it is a successor of Weebill S. Weebill 2 is basically a full-size gimbal with higher payload and also higher weight. Weebill 3 is much lighter and more compact gimbal. It is basically in a different class than the Weebill 2. It weighs just 1.1 kg and it still fits on A4 paper, which is a signature feature of the Weebill series. Unlike the lab configuration, this new configuration stores the batteries in the bottom of the gimbal. That moves the center of the balance down and it doesn't interfere in any way, so I think that it is a good idea. Comfortable sling shooting is still possible with an included handle which can be connected to the rosette on the bottom part. The wrist rest is also available and it can decrease the strain as well. There isn't an official maximal payload. Zhiyun provides a compatibility list which includes camera and lens combinations. I have tested it with Sony A7 IV, Sigma 24-70mm f2.8 DGDN, and magnetic variable ND filters. This combination weighs about 1.5 kg, but it is quite front heavy. This kind of setup is completely fine on Weebill 3. I have mostly used it with a lighter setups, such as A7 IV with 24mm GM, and that is completely fine as well, of course. The build quality is very good. The arms are metal with plastic inserts and the rest of the construction is mostly made of high quality plastics. The standard package comes in a foam case. Besides the gimbal, you will get the table tripod, Manfrotto plate, quick release plate, lens support accessories, substantial amount of cables and color adapters for the fill light. Combo package adds the wrist rest, sling handle and a backpack, but I don't have that one yet. Weebill 3 is pretty easy to balance, much like Weebill 2. It has a locking mechanism on all axes, which is helpful for balancing and even more importantly for transportation. Tilt and roll axes use levers instead of screws, which also makes the balancing faster and the axes are very easy to move, so fine adjustments are easy to do. Weebill 2 also has an auto-tune function, much like most modern gimbals, and it works very well. Only the pan axis has unlimited motion range, but that is the one that matters, so that is fine. That is a very acceptable price for using stronger motors, which usually don't allow unlimited motion range on tilt and roll axes. One of very few complaints that I have about this gimbal is the mounting mechanism. It uses Manfrotto style plates, which is fine, and there is also a quick release system, but it is not Arca compatible. Fortunately, there is an easy solution in a form of small rig 3061 quick release plate. It allows you to use any Arca compatible plate, including my favorite Peak Design standard plates, and it even has a safety pin for those. This is, in my opinion, an absolute must have for any gimbal without a similar solution. Regarding the smoothness and the stabilization itself, Weebill 3 is the first gimbal that I am testing with in-body image stabilization in Sony A7 IV. IBIS in A7 IV is more effective than A7 III IBIS that I've used so far, but the bottom line is that the performance of this combination is absolutely fantastic. It at least matches the performance of full-size gimbals that I've tested with A7 III. The motors are very responsive and predictable, so man and machine coordination is not a problem. This is actually the 10th version of Zhiyun's algorithm and that is noticeable. I have mostly tested it with 24mm G Master. Despite that this is not an ultra-wide focal length, the vibrations are barely visible. The walking is usually a weakness of this kind of light gimbals, but not in this case. Getting this kind of flank camera effect at 24mm is super easy with Weebill 3. I was able to get very stable push shots even on the cobblestones. I guess that the A7 IV IBIS helps a lot with the Z-axis. Despite that, it still won't cause any warping at all, so it is completely fine and very highly recommended to leave it on a gimbal. I am also very happy with the joystick. The speed of all three axes can be adjusted separately, and I was always able to get very smooth panning using the joystick. Overall, I am very happy with the performance of Weebill 3 in combination with A7 IV. I will have to retest the Weebill 2 with A7 IV to put it into the context, but this performance is just amazing. Very complete motor parameter settings also contribute to the overall performance of Weebill 3. It has a small 1-inch monochrome screen, which is not the most impressive gimbal display. You can still set everything, including the follow speed, dead zone, joystick responsiveness, roundy auto-tuning, and so on using this display. It is controlled by the wheel and menu button on the right side of the gimbal, which is actually pretty convenient. I was able to change the settings pretty quickly after I got used to it. The grip is exceptionally well shaped. These horizontal areas let you rest the weight on the top of your hand, which decreases the strain on your forearms. The joystick is placed in the reach of your thumb, which means that you don't have to loosen the handle to reach it. Mode switch is also well placed and easy to operate. It lets you cycle between three base follow modes, and double press lets you cycle between POV, vortex, and portrait mode. There is also a video recording button, a trigger button, and a controller wheel. Overall, I really like the ergonomy on Weebill 3. Zhiyun did a great job here. There are basically 7 follow modes on this gimbal. There is the pan follow mode, where the gimbal follows your movement in horizontal axis. Pan and tilt follow mode follows your horizontal movements and tilting of the gimbal. In the lock mode, it will keep the camera pointed in one direction. In POV mode, it follows all axes, so panning, tilting, and rolling. Go mode is basically a sports mode where the gimbal follows movements faster. Of course, you can enter selfie mode by triple pressing the trigger button, and you can reset the position of the gimbal by double pressing the trigger. The portrait or vertical mode will rotate the camera by 90 degrees, which is very useful for shooting high production value stories. Vortex mode for vertigo effect is also available. Weebill 3 has an integrated fill light that we know from smaller Zhiyun gimbals. It is small but quite powerful at 1000 nits. It is also very soft, which is quite suitable for a fill light. You can change the brightness and color temperature using the dial on the right side. I think that it can be useful especially as a fill light, so it is a good idea in my opinion. Another very interesting feature of the Weebill 3 is the built-in microphone. Mounting a microphone to the gimbal is a bit of a pain, so this is a very clever way to get better audio without cluttering your gimbal setup. The audio quality is comparable to compact shotgun microphones, but with that significant benefit of not cluttering your setup. It probably won't replace a proper shotgun microphone, but it can still be very convenient in a lot of situations, so I think that it is a good idea. I wasn't able to test the ZY Play app with Weebill 3, but it always worked very well with other gimbals. The app includes the usual features such as the remote control, parameter settings, motion lapses, and so on. It is also possible to connect the camera to the gimbal using included cables. Pre-production unit didn't have the necessary firmware, so I wasn't able to test it yet. As always, I recommend simply using the buttons on the camera anyway. It is a hassle-free option and it always works. Weebill 3 uses an integrated 7800 mAh battery. That is a lot of milliamp hours, so it should give you 21 hours of use time, which is probably the best of all gimbals on the market. It still shows full bars after my standard review usage, so I'm obviously very happy with that. The charging is very fast at about 2 hours. It can also recharge the camera at 5 watts. The battery life is definitely another standout feature of the Weebill 3. Weebill 3 will work with the whole ecosystem of Zhiyun accessories, including the TransMount image transmission system. To sum up, Zhiyun Weebill 3 is, in my opinion, one of the most significant gimbals in a long time. First of all, the size-to-performance ratio of the Weebill 3 in combination with A7 IV is phenomenal. Again, I'm not sure how much of the credit goes to the A7 IV IBIS, but the overall smoothness is incredible. The gimbal is very small and light, so it is very travel friendly and quite easy to work with. The ergonomy is also a standout feature of the Weebill 3. The addition of the fill light and built-in microphones makes it more versatile without cluttering the setup. The battery life and the charging are also class-leading. The only minor complaint that I have is that it doesn't work with ARCA plates, but I have easily fixed that with a small rig plate. Weebill 3 is, in my opinion, a worthy successor to previous lightweight Weebill gimbals. It provides great performance and very complete feature set in a compact package, so I can highly recommend it. So that's it for this video, thank you for watching, I hope that you liked this video and that you have found it to be useful. Stay tuned for more videos and maybe consider subscribing if you don't want to miss my future content. I appreciate your feedback in form of thumbs up or thumbs down. If you would like to ask anything or share your opinion, please do so in the comment section, and see you next time.